Alright, so let's get off that that course heading. Man, we are cruising. 200 knots, man.
Jeez.
You know, a little bit about the way a Bonanza flies. I'm going to go ahead and take it off autopilot, and then I'm going to hand the controls over to Colby and let him fly it for a little while. But the, you know, the Bonanza, it has very light control inputs, a lot like the RV. And it's different than a Cessna. We've, you know, I've flown in Cessnas, Pipers, you know, all kinds of different airplanes. Cirrus, almost bought a Cirrus actually instead of buying this one. Actually went through the full training and made an offer on one. And I'm glad the guy said no, because insurance for those Cirrus are ridiculous. You know, I bought this Bonanza and I had never even been in one. I just thought, you know, that V-tail looks so cool. You know, it's got to fly good. And it was a good guess, because it did it. I'm very happy with the airplane. Anyways, so I bought this airplane literally sight unseen. And, you know, the first time I got an instructor who knew Bonanzas and got in it, flew it away. And, you know, I've been happy ever since. So, ended up being a pretty good thing. The other thing about a Bonanza, they're just really easy to land. I mean, they, you know, they land like a Cessna 182, you know, and I think a 182 lands even better than a 172. You know, they land very similar approach speeds. I carry a little bit more speed on approach than I would in a Cessna, but it's more just because I can. Okay, let's change direct to KFT. Okay, so we're now we're only doing 103 knots, so we got a pretty good wind up here. 101 knots. Good lord. That's slow on us. So we're about 20 minutes away from the airport. I'm going to actually throw this yoke over and let Colby fly. So Colby, I want you to keep us straight and level, okay? Here, I'll put up synthetic vision. Now I want you to stay below 8,000 feet. Okay, so you're losing some altitude at 500 feet a minute. Movements in the air, no fast control inputs. So right now we're indicating about 130, but we're actually only doing 96 knots, and that's, you know, I could wide open throttle this thing and we could go faster, but let's just let you get used to flying it. Here we are heading back to front range. Not much to see really, it's all just flat out here. So I want you, instead of focusing on that synthetic vision, I want you just to focus on the horizon and pick a point on that horizon. Do you see the white tents of DIA off there in the distance?
Yeah.
Why don't you point the airplane over there. Okay, level out. There you go. Nice, good input. And just hold it right there. Now remember, I want you to keep it below 8,000. Okay? And I want you to just pick that point on the horizon, those white tents of DIA, and just keep the nose pointed there and maintain this altitude. You got this. This one's actually a lot easier to fly than the RV, huh?
I think the RV is easier.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So not too long ago, Colby and I flew up to Wyoming and went fishing, and he flew the whole way there. I never turned the autopilot on once. He was my autopilot. Okay, so EGTs and CHTs are good, oil pressure's good, cylinder temperatures are good, oil temperature's good, fuel flow's good, 19 inches of manifold pressure, 2300 RPM, we are in good shape. Okay, so what I want you to start doing, as we approach this Class Bravo ring here, we can go to, we can be at 10,000 feet until we hit that line, then we have to be below 8,000. And then down to 7,000 to approach at front range. So you're doing a great job, though. 8,000 or 7,900 feet. good steady course. But we're flying at Cessna speeds right now. So we've probably got a 30 knot, 35 knot headwind right now. What do you think?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and change fuel. Now, every time we change fuel, we watch our fuel flow. Make sure that nothing changes there. Okay, so you see all that traffic depicted on there?
Yep. We're getting close. Oh.
Yeah, so we got a bogey right out here. Got two or three over here. This is what happens on a nice day of flying. I think a lot of that traffic comes from Centennial.
Yeah.
No. See, Colby's all decked out in his basketball stuff. He's got a couple of games today. We wanted to come out here and get a little airtime before his basketball. You gonna crush this today or what?
Yeah, you know it.
Yeah, you know it. Enthusiastic.
Oh yeah, that's me.
Okay, so we're 25.8 miles out, and we'll call it kind of 10 to 12 miles. But then now we're coming in. Okay, so we're just entering that class, underneath that class Bravo shelf there. And you're still at 7,900, so that's perfect. That's I-70 down there. Basically just follow that all the way to the airport. You're a pretty good pilot, huh? You know, we fly this Bonanza a lot. I use it for work, commuting mostly to and from Iowa and to and from Phoenix, South Dakota, Salt Lake City. And, you know, when I'm flying by myself, most of the time I'll fly the RV, but if anybody's flying with me, this Bonanza is really comfortable. I mean, they're kind of like sitting in an SUV. So I want you to start losing some altitude there. What I want you to do is no fast inputs on the yoke. Just kind of watch this vertical speed indicator here and kind of put it at 500 feet so you'll push forward just slightly. Perfect. Okay, hold that right there. That took our ground speed up to 117 and our indicated up to 140. So what we want to do is just 500 feet down, let's actually change the trim here so you don't have to push so hard. Feel how that kind of does the work for you?
Yeah.
And we're gonna do a similar video to this for the RV. So kind of its systems, but when you know, we wanted that plane to be more of a you know, more of a steam gauge kind of airplane. We didn't want all the digital stuff we've got here. We ended up with some in the form of a Dynan, but beyond that, it's mostly a, we just wanted it to be a stick and rudder airplane, which it is, and it's very good at that. So we'll do a, do another video on that. What do you say?
Heck yeah.
Heck yeah. All right, so I'm showing you 20 miles out, and at about 15 miles, I'll take the yoke back from you, okay?
Okay.
Is it a lot of force to...
No, not really.
Ooh, weightless. Feel yourself fly out of that seat?
Yeah, I hit my head a couple times.
Now, do you feel that adverse yaw? That, do you feel that waggle in the wing or in the tail?
Yeah.
That's caused... You know, that's one of the things people complain about in the Bonanza. This airplane has a stinger tail cone on it, which eliminates some of that, but so I don't make passengers sick. I typically fly with 1 foot sitting on the rudder. All right, you're at 7,000 feet, so let's go ahead and level off to below 7,000 so that as we get under that. Feel that wind and all the buffeting going on.
Yeah.
I don't even notice that waggle anymore, really.
Yeah, I don't really notice the waggle, unless I'm in the back.
Yeah. Alright, well I'm going to take this thing back over, and next video, next part of this video will be our approach and landing, so stay tuned.
So like my favorite flying, it depends on the airplane, but like I like going to the mountains for like a weekend in the RV, or like going to another state in the RV, but like long trips like to Iowa would probably be better in this because it's so much more comfortable.
Yeah, like when we flew to Casey's basketball tournament, that was
fun.
Yeah. So alright, I'm going to go ahead and call Front Range Tower here.
Bonanza 18368, Front Range Tower, ident. Bonanza 368, ident observed, altitude indicate 6,800, make sure and approach runway 26, report Skippy.
So 5 miles out, we'll do our first jumps check.
But the second one will be at...
You know, the second one is less formal, I just kind of do it in my head, make sure I've gone through everything. The other thing in a Bonanza is, you know, since you have retractable landing gear, you never touch the flaps before you touch the gear, okay? And the reason for that is, it's really hard to slow this airplane down. Not really hard, but it's hard to slow this thing down without the undercarriage down. But you can do it with the flaps. So you want to slow down with the putting the undercarriage down, create some drag, and then go to the flaps. Skippy is right here on the map. So that's a 5 mile final from okay, so we got the field in sight. Coming up on Skippy.
Bonanza 368, number 2, following Cessna over Skippy, 6,800, about your 1 o'clock, just outside of a mile.
Do you see that little square on the ground right there with all those solar panels around it?
Yeah.
That's the, that's Skippy.
Bonanza
right
368, report when you have that Cessna traffic in sight. Speed indicates 60 knots.
Okay, so gas is set, undercarriage, mixture is set. We're doing 100 knots. We're going to overrun that Cessna. I still don't see him. Do you see
him? Bonanza 368, you can do some S-turns to follow that traffic build from space. He's at your 12 o'clock, 6,500 inside of a mile now.
368, I've got the traffic.
Bonanza 368, runway 26, cleared land number 2.
368, cleared land number 2.
You know how I'm doing big old S-turns here and... catching up to that Cessna.
Cessna 7 Kilo Alpha, runway 26, go around.
Go around 26, go out.
Bonanza 368, runway 26, clear to land, traffic clock's going around.
368, thank you for that.
Okay, so we got three greens, gas is set, undercarriage set, mixture set,
hotel world,
set.
Wind 273 at 21, gust 27.
Wow, 27 not gust, huh?
Lot of wind.
That's alright, we got this. Alright,
here's what the please.
Everything's set.
270 at 21, gusting 27.
Okay, we just hit the glide slope, so we're in good shape here. Wind is howling, I can feel it. Right. That was pretty. Okay, YouTube, we are back at the hangar here, and gonna put this thing away and watch Colby go crush it in basketball. Thanks for flying with us today. Hope you found it fun.
Like, comment, and subscribe, and I hope you enjoyed this video.
Alright.